Hi, I'm Darrell, and I'm a technical training consultant at SAS. My focus is on SAS administrators and making sure they have the information and tools necessary to manage your SAS Viya environment. Today, we're going to be looking at the SAS Viya CLI, or command line interface. SAS is built on top of a REST architecture. Now, I'm not going to get into what a REST architecture is. It's been around for over 20 years, and there's plenty of information out on the internet. I've even given you some below. The CLI uses REST APIs to communicate with the SAS Viya environment. However, you don't have to know how to write REST API calls. It's all handled for you by the SAS Viya CLI. Now, what I'm going to be showing is how to install the SAS Viya CLI, how to download and install the plugins, how to configure it to communicate with your SAS Viya environment. Then I'll show you some examples on how to use the SAS Viya CLI. Now, let's get started. First off, we need to go to support.sas.com, but I'm already here. And I'm already logged in. I do want to point out that SAS Administrator's desktop has been selected. There's a standard desktop, which most programmers and other users would be more interested in, but I've selected the SAS Administrator's desktop, which gives me quick access to all of the content that is most important to me. Scrolling down, there's a row here of boxes, links, that one of them is downloads and hotfixes. We'll be coming back to that one, but first, I want to point out, as we scroll a little further, there is a link for SAS Viya administration documentation. So don't forget that when I refer you to the documentation, here's where you can find it. So let's scroll back up now and go to our downloads and hotfixes. If I go to the S's and near the bottom, I'll find the SAS Viya CLI, and there it is. I want to point out here that the SAS Viya CLI can be used to manage a remote Viya environment from your Windows system, a Macintosh system, or a Linux environment. I'm going to Windows, so I'm going to download the zip file. Now, we'll need to accept the license information. So let's go to the downloads folder, and I am going to move that to a special location. I'm going to move it to the C drive and a folder I already have set up, and unpack it here and move the executable to that folder as well. Now I'm ready to go. I do need to open up a command window. I'm going to use PowerShell. Back up to my Viya directory, and I see the plugins.bat and the sas-viya.exe. The SAS Viya CLI requires plugins. They're like connectors to connect the SAS Viya CLI to a particular component within the SAS Viya environment. Now, I have written the little bat file here to expedite the process for us. If we look at it, I see that I'm actually using the SAS Viya CLI with the plugins command to install from the SAS repository each individual plugin. Now I need to do that because if I run the SAS Viya command, use that plugins command with the list option, I don't have any plugins. So don't forget, once you've downloaded the SAS Viya CLI, to download your plugins. Now, if I run this bat file, now that I've gotten them installed, I can do the plugins list again and see the version. I can also use that plugins command and list repo plugins for the repository. And you can do a comparison. Make sure that you keep those in sync. All right, so we've downloaded the plugins. We do have to establish the connection with our SAS Viya environment. To do that, we have to set up a profile. Now you can have multiple profiles. If you have a dev, test, and prod environment, then you can set up a dev profile, a test profile, and a production profile. I'm just going to set up the default profile. And I do that by using my SAS Viya. I'll be doing that a lot today with the profile command, and I'm going to initialize it. Now I need to provide the service endpoint. If you look at the URLs for your SAS Viya applications like SAS Studio, SAS Environment Manager, that is a good place to start. So I'm going to put in http:// server.demo.sas.com because that's where my Viya environment is set up. You have the option of setting the output type to text, JSON, or full JSON. If you use JSON, it's a little more readable for most. And if you ever need to go back to a text output, there's an option on the CLI to change the output, override the default output to another one. And I'll actually show you that a little later. For now, like I said, I'm going to use JSON here, and I do not like the colored output. Your mileage may vary. Give it a shot. And I have created my default profile, and that's what it says there at the bottom, saved default profile, and it's in my users area. Now that I've got my profile, I need a token. The Viya environment requires a valid token to communicate with it. The Viya CLI is a recognized SAS application, and it's real easy to do that. So to get the token, I use the SAS Viya CLI. This time I use the auth login command, and I'm going to log in with a user I know that's over there, Christine. The login succeeded and the token has been saved. Now that token is valid for 12 hours. So in 12 hours, I got to do this again. So you need to remember that auth login. Or another nice feature of the SAS Viya CLI is that you can write and create scripts. So repeatable processes you have to do every day, every week. You can write scripts and just run the script instead of going to the SAS Environment Manager web interface or typing in the commands every week. Write you a script and off you go. Just submit those or schedule them to be executed at the desired time. All right, now that I'm logged in, I've got my token, I'm communicating with my Viya environment. Let's run some of the commands that you might find useful. The first one I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Identities plugin with the list users command. And I see the JSON output, I see the list of users that have been registered to my SAS Viya environment. This is a good place. This is one of those where I like the output a little better in a textual format, and it's going to come out in rows instead of these blocks of information. So I will set the output to text, and there's the difference. JSON on top, text on the bottom. Managing users, you also manage groups. So now let's use the Identities plugin once again and create a group. So I'm in the education group. Let's call this the education group, and the ID is also education. Group was created successfully. What goes in groups? Well, users go in groups. So let's add a user to our newly created education group. Once again, we're using the identities. This time it's going to be the add member command. Put it in this new education group. And who do we want to put in there? We're going to go ahead and put Lynn. Output there, notification, Lynn has been added to our education group. All right, so we just added the group for education. We just added Lynn to that education group. One of the other things as an administrator you might have to do is add some folders or places in the SAS Viya content structure for that new group to add content. And that's what I'm going to show you next. Remember I said that you could install and set up the SAS Viya CLI on Linux. So I've done that. I've already got it set up. I've already got the plugins installed, and I've already got my profile and token. So everything's good. Let's first go to the workshop directory. In here, I've got three scripts. One for add group. Let me show you that one real quick. Three things to point out here. First, what if the token is expired? Well, the lines that follow in this script are going to fail, or the whole script is going to fail. The first line there is, I have created a script to log Christine in automatically in these scripts that she's running. All right, so logged in. The token's expired. Don't have to worry about it. It's there. Now, do be careful because how you set that up, how you secure that, because there could be a password that's a no-no. Don't put passwords in files, but there's really not a way around it in this particular case. So what I've done here is I've got the script that creates the education group, and then it adds Lynn to that new group. If you wanted to take this script and parameterize it, meaning add group minus G education for group equals education and minus U Lynn, you could use this script repeatedly with different groups and different users. So think about that. Again, these scripts are wonderful things in my opinion. The other script here, the add folder. So I've added the group, I've put members in that group. Now I'm going to add a folder, and let's look at that one. Yeah, these are very simple, but you can get real complex with them. I'm going to show you that in just a second as well. So in this one, what I've got is I'm going to create a new folder. All right, it's an education folder. And again, I could use this with a parameter with add folder .sh minus F or minus N, however you want to set it up, and education. So folder or name for the folder. Use the parameters, run the script with different folder names. Let's go ahead and run this particular script. And the folder was created successfully. I also have Environment Manager open here. It was in the SAS content section. Let me refresh it, and there is my education folder. Now I want to look at the other script that was in that directory. That was in the workshop directory. And it's a Python script. Now this is one that will stop sessions. And if we look at it, we will see that it takes different parameters. So in this usage section, there's stopsessions.py. You can do a dash dash user or dash u and add a username. And it will terminate all of the user's sessions, all of that user's sessions. It also takes a session parameter. It's either or, it's either user or session. It will terminate all of a user's sessions or a particular session that you provide on the command line. And here's further examples. So stop sessions py minus u Darrell, it would stop all of my sessions. If this was the URI for, or the ID for one of my sessions, then it would stop that particular one. Now, without digging too deeply into this, just wanted to show you a couple of lines here. CLI path is it's pointing to a specific location where my SAS Viya CLI is located. And then I plug it in here. And then my output is JSON. I'm going to use the CAS plugin. I'm going to list all of the sessions for the user that I specified on the command line. So I've added a parameter here. There's more to it, but that's all I'm going to show you now.
Thanks for watching. There's more links below about the SAS Viya CLI. Please leave a comment or ask a question if you have them. And don't forget to subscribe.